Robbinsdale swinging in, and it's a fair ball, and Wayzata wins it. Champlin Park back to state for the third straight year.
Hello and welcome to Sports Jam for the week of November 12th. I'm John Jacobson.
And I'm Jay Wilcox. This week on the show, section swimming and diving highlights. And in our Sports Jam spotlight, we'll hear from three juniors who made under-the-radar contributions to Champlin Park's great volleyball season.
And speaking of the Rebels, we'll get started with their week at the state tournament. Champlin Park was in the state tourney for a fifth straight season and certainly one of the favorites to win it all coming in. Coach John Unker's team opened the tournament against unseeded Moorhead in the 3A quarterfinals. First set, Izzy Ashburn sets the ball to Lauren Clark. Her attack off the back row player and out. Rebels lead 11-4 in the first set. They win at 25-15. Second set, Caitlin Weimerskirch passes to Ashburn. Her back set to Hannah Prasky for the kill. Helps the Rebels break open a close set. They win 25-17 to go up 2-0. 25-18, rather. Then the third set, it's Ashburn. And Sami Hilley delivers one of her seven kills in the match. The Rebels win again. They sweep Moorhead for the team's 30th win of the season. Well, that put Champlin Park into the semifinals. Well, they met third seed Lakeville South for a second time this year. Cougars forced the Rebels into some early errors, and late in set one, it's Jasmine Mulvihill with a kill, and South wins the first set 27-25. But the Rebels regroup. Set two, Ashburn sets up Clark for a kill. Rebels lead 12-7, and they win 25-21, evening the match at one. Set three, player of the year Ashburn sets it to Emma Schmidt. She leads with 16 kills this day. Champlin Park wins 25-18. And they continue to roll in the fourth set. Jordan Stalpes with the kill. Champlin Park wins in four sets and they move to the championship match. So for the second time in three seasons, Champlin Park met Egan for the Class 3A title. The Wildcats won that one back in 2016, and they were in the state championship match for a sixth straight year. Good start for the Rebels. Lauren Clark with an ace serve. Champlin Park out to a 7-1 lead to begin the match. Egan's Ling Wong gets blocked by Ashburn on set point. Champlin Park wins 25-18 to get the early edge. After trailing early in set two, Schmidt with a block for the Rebels, tying the score at 12. Champlin Park puts together a 10-1 scoring run in the middle of the set. Hannah Prasky with a kill here as the Rebels win 25-18. But Egan doesn't get rattled. Third set, Kaylin Madison bumps the ball back to Wong, giving the Wildcats a 15-12 lead. They win the set 25-21. In set four, Egan's all-state hitter and setter Kennedy Orr delivers some big points. The Wildcats win that one 25-22, pushing this match to a fifth and deciding set. Hilley with a big block early, putting Champlin Park ahead in the fifth set, 6-2. And this one stays close and late. It's Clark with a huge block on Orr's attack. Champlin Park leads 13-11. And then at 14-12, Orr serves into the net. That's match point, and the celebration is on. Champlin Park wins in five sets to capture their first state title. A big win not only for the program, for Champlin Park as a whole as well.
I know we got some individual sports and individual athletes win state stuff. It's the first team banner for the school in 27 years. So it's not just a big deal for these girls and the volleyball program, but it was a pretty big deal for the school.
We've been to state multiple times, so like being able to accomplish our goal finally, it just feels amazing. And it was like a lot of pressure going into it because we wanted to be able to do that for our school.
As Izzy has said multiple times in the past, that we're very competitive, which has made all of us better. And it's super fun because they pushed me to become a better person and a player. And yeah, it's super cool. I love playing with them. I'm going to miss.
Today, an exciting day for all of those girls who made a state championship run. And they get a state championship title out of it again in the end against Egan.
Yeah, they've been close in a lot of other sports, a lot of second place finishes. Yeah. I didn't realize really until that day that that was actually the first one, so congratulations to the Rebels. Well, one of the area's best high school athletes made his college choice public. BREC three-sport athlete David Roddy announced his college choice at a ceremony at the school last Friday. Roddy will attend and play basketball at Colorado State University next year. He's a gifted athlete. In addition to starring for the Mustangs on the hardwood, Roddy is one of the state's top quarterbacks for the football team. He says he'll miss football, but ultimately basketball and Colorado State just felt right.
You know, it took me a while to kind of cope with things and, you know, research schools and spend hours and hours of discussion with my parents and, you know, my mentors, giving me advice about, you know, certain schools and certain people. And they always ended up at the top. So, you know, it was a good decision. And, you know, I went with my gut and, you know, I'm really happy.
Best of luck to David. I know he'll do well out there.
Yeah, he had a lot of options. We have one more season to watch him on the court this winter for Breck. Straight ahead on Sports Jam, some great competition at Sexer Girls Swimming and Diving Meets. We'll be right back.
Welcome back to Sports Jam. Spots in the State Girls Swimming and Diving Meet were up for grabs over the weekend.
And three local teams captured section championships. Armstrong's one of several local teams competing in Section 5AA. 200 individual medley. It's White Zeta finishing 1-2. Jordan McGinty wins. Melinda Zhang places second. Armstrong's Grace Wolschlager and Molly Zook of Armstrong and Allison Hall of Hopkins also make state from that race. 53, Ellen Hofstad of Hopkins touches home first in 24.16 seconds. Champlin Park's Heather Johnson of Silver Cap finishes second and also makes state. 100-yard butterfly, a great race for Hopkins' Molly Nealand. She wins in 54.61 seconds. Wayzetta Zhang and Carr Ranke also qualify for state, along with Armstrong's Wolschlager and Amber Kroonquist of Osseo. Milan, though, sets a new section and pool record with her time. 100 freestyle, Sierra Smith of Armstrong outcatches McGinty by 1/100th of a second to win. Hofstad and Jenna Marquette of Wayzetta also make state. Smith sets a new pool record. 51.11 is her time. 500 free, Zoe Bresnahan of Armstrong places first. Her time, 5:01.25. Armstrong Zook, along with Antoni Hopp and Madison Rundle of Wayzetta, makes state in the 500 as well. 100 breaststroke, Jenna Marquette of Wayzetta takes first. Hall of Hopkins comes in second, but it's Wayzetta winning the section. And here's what a couple of their swimmers had to say after the meet.
I'm super pumped. Our team actually performed so well. I'm so proud of everyone. Lots of great swims. I can't wait to see what we can do at state.
I think we can do top three. I think it's a goal that we all have. It's a fast pool. They have really good boards. And as long as we do the same thing we did tonight, we're going to do great at state.
Wayzetta rolls to the team title with 598 points, well ahead of runner-up Hopkins. Armstrong is third, followed by Champlin Park. Osseo places seventh, and Park Center is eighth.
Maple Grove is in Section 8AA. The Crimson won the true team title earlier this season and hope to match that at the official section meet. Elk River's Vandenberg Middle School, the site for the finals. In the 200 freestyle, in the yellow cap, St. Michael Albertville's Ashton Hobza races to the win. Abby Cornelius of Maple Grove is second to advance to state. Caitlin Arseth of the Crimson has to settle for fourth. The 200 IM, STMA's Kelsey Koken wins in a time of 2:10.47. Freshman Lily Chabika of Maple Grove qualifies for state with her second place finish. In the 50 free, Maple Grove's Madeline Bass just holds off Buffalo's Tiana Kosek to win by 2/100ths of a second. On to diving, and here is the section champ. St. Cloud Tech's Meredith Machinsky scores a 3:99.0 to take the title. Maple Grove gets a state qualifier in diving as well, as Morgan Bosacker places fourth with a total of 3:47.55 to advance. Back to swimming, and Maple Grove dominates in the 500 freestyle. Cornelius rolls to the win in a time of 5:15.61. Her teammate Caitlin Arseth also advances by placing second, some 9 seconds back. Maple Grove takes four of the top five spots in the race. In the 400 free relay, it's Buffalo racing to the title. Maple Grove is second, scoring more valuable points and helping the Crimson to the team title.
It's a dream come true. I couldn't imagine this team doing any better today, and I'm so excited for all the girls that are coming with me to state this year. Honestly, we had a pretty good feeling coming into the meet, but after diving was completed and we saw that we were ahead, we just knew it was ours because we've always been a second half team.
As we check the team scores, Maple Grove is well ahead of the competition with 450 points. Buffalo is second, followed by St. Michael, Albertville, and Brainerd. Rogers places sixth. In Section 2A, Breck takes the top spot, winning 8 of the 12 events. Spinilda second and Blake third. Fridley and Totino Grace have a combined program and finished fifth. Cooper is eighth. The state meet is this week at the U of M Aquatic Center. Champions will be crowned this weekend at the State Adapted Soccer Tournament, too. Some local teams figure to be top contenders. The Robbinsdale Hopkins Mound West Tonka Robbins PI Division runner-up last season and winners of seven titles in a row from 2008 through 2014 are the top seed from the North. They face Minneapolis South in the quarterfinals Friday at 5 p.m. North number three seed Anoka Hennepin faces defending champion Dakota United at 5. Park Center, the second seed from the North, plays Rochester Friday at 6:30. The semifinals are Saturday morning and the championship Saturday afternoon at 2:30 in the PI division at Stillwater. In the CI division, just one local team made the state tournament field, but they're a good one. Defending champion Park Center is the top seed from the North, and they carry a 7-2 record into this year's tournament. The Pirates take on South Suburban in the quarterfinals at 5 o'clock Friday. The semifinals are Saturday at noon with the title game at 4 o'clock in the CI division. And John, we'll see if the Robins and or Pirates can bring home titles this year.
Good luck to them this weekend. Better balance now, though. Both divisions, in both divisions, won't be easy, the road to state. Next up in our Sports Jam Spotlight, meet a trio of Champlin Park juniors who played big roles for the state champion Rebels volleyball team.
As we saw earlier, the Champlin Park volleyball team had a fantastic season that ended in a state title. In this week's Sports Jam Spotlight, we meet three Rebels who played a big, if sometimes overlooked, role in the team's success.
Aspern back to Schmidt. A star-studded senior class for the Champlin Park volleyball team drew plenty of headlines, and deservedly so. But the future leaders, juniors Jordan Stalpes, Hannah Prasky, and Sami Hilley, certainly made some big contributions to the team.
I think it's been really important because, like, it's helped our team since we have hitters in every position and every age. So, like, when they're gone, then we have us too.
We know we're going to lose, like, a lot of talented seniors next year, but we're excited to, like, just keep working and, like, bring it next year.
It's been super important to have them. They're great leaders, and they're going to be great leaders, and just having them on the court has helped so much, especially just they come out expecting the seniors to do all the work when, in reality, the juniors are somebody to watch out for, and I think they just help a ton.
Rebels coach John Yonker appreciates what the junior trio of Stalpes, Prasky, and Hilley brought to this year's team and also knows they'll be players he can count on in the future.
They kind of fly under the radar sometimes a little bit because of, you know, what we have with the senior class, and they contributed some last year as sophomores, and even Jordan a little bit as a freshman, but it was fun watching them all come into their own over the years. Sami, towards the end of the year last year, really came into her own and just was on fire at the state tournament and made the all-tournament team, and then that's carried over into this year, and Hannah's stronger and improved, and Jordan's out there. She's taking on a bigger role in the back row for us and been great in serve, receive, and of course our offense.
Hilley and Stalpes ranked third and fourth respectively on the Rebels in kills this season, while Prasky led the team in total blocks entering the state tournament. They freely admit that learning from older players in the Rebels program has made a big difference for them.
Oh, so much. Just them being so welcoming and just more experience just gives us a lot more.
We know they're super good, so it's exciting to, like, learn off of them, like, learn the stuff they do. And, like, for them to coach you, like, personally, like, they'll tell you, like, what you're doing wrong and stuff, and it's, like, super helpful.
It goes without saying that the returning Champlin Park players would like to return to the XL Center for another state tournament. It's a special experience that they'd like to share with future Rebels teammates.
Aspern back to Stalpes, and there it is.
Oh, it's 100% different. Just the atmosphere, and everyone just brings their game, and there's so much more competition, and it's just a whole experience going.
Stalpes joined her senior teammates Izzy Aspern, Emma Schmidt, and Katie Weimerskirch on the Class 3A All-Tournament team. We'll have a look back at two of our favorite spotlight stories from the fall when Sports Jam continues. The Wayzata girls soccer team had an outstanding season this fall that ended up with a state runner-up finish. Two of the Trojans' leaders were midfielder Lily Gilbertson and goalkeeper Madison Lowe. Jason Malillo caught up with the two seniors during the Section 6AA tournament for this Sports Jam Spotlight.
Wayzata senior Lily Gilbertson hasn't scored as much this fall as she did last year, and that's been a bit frustrating.
I always think of it like a point is a point, and even if I'm not always getting points, it matters how the team is doing. So obviously sometimes I'm a little frustrated, like I need to be scoring more, but Tony has always said just focus on what you're doing and how you're helping the team.
And Gilbertson has helped the team. After being a top attacker last year, Gilbertson moved to midfielder this fall, where the Trojans were thin going into the season.
It's just different for me because I'm not looking to score as much. I'm looking to like distribute and do other things. But I don't know, we have such amazing forwards, and the other center mids that we have are also super strong. So it's been really fun and it's been a challenge, but I think at this point, I'm just excited to continue doing what we've been doing as a team.
Despite scoring only three goals this year, Gilbertson leads the team with 11 assists. But her value to the team goes beyond stats.
At the end of the day, people are always looking at stats. And if they had a stat that said the second assist, well, Lily would probably be leading the state in that. Now, we've told her, you may not get credit for those, but we know the value of those and how important they are, and so does the team. You know, she's clearly a player that is very instrumental in everything we do. She's the core master. She runs the show and doesn't always get credit for it, but our record has been pretty good, so she's done a pretty good job.
With much of the team in flux throughout the fall, the Trojans have been solid at goalie, where senior Maddie Lowe is in her second season as the starter.
Very athletic. I mean, she makes some spectacular saves, practices in games. So she's got that ability to really stand out and has a, you know, she can have a little panache and a little flair in there because she's got those abilities to do. And she's pretty steady, pretty reliable.
Lowe describes herself as aggressive, and she certainly seems to play with no fear.
I think that's just kind of how I've been trained. I've dealt with some injuries. I had 27 stitches because I got cleated one time. So I think like after I had that, like nothing's really phasing me anymore. Everything's like, I know just like that's a style that works for me and that's just how I play. And no matter what time, like no matter what time of the game it is, no matter who we're playing, that's just like the style I play. And so I think that just like, it allows me to be more successful when I play that way.
Gilbertson and Lowe are very good friends and started playing soccer together when they were 6 years old. And leaving Wayzata won't be the end of that friendship, because both girls will be student athletes at Northwestern University next fall.
It wasn't my initial thing of like go where Lily goes, but it did. I think it was like a nice thing to know that like I'm going to Northwestern and I'm gonna have someone there. And the coaches really emphasize like they're not gonna like room us together or anything, but they're just like they're still gonna let us like it's gonna be nice that we know people and help us branch out, I think.
Gilbertson was one of four Trojans players named to the all-tournament team at state.
The Cooper football team had another strong season, going 8-2 and losing in the Section 5-5A final. We caught up with two outstanding senior wide receivers in an October Spotlight story.
Cooper wide receivers Pedro Amusu and Adrian Adams have proved to be a dangerous pair for opposing teams to defend this fall. The two seniors combined for 15 receiving touchdowns in 8 regular season games, with each guy averaging more than 22 yards per catch.
We do a lot of bubble screens, as you guys know. We can also go deep to Adrian and a couple other guys. And I think we're always looking to score when we touch the ball to get a big game. So I think that's what really makes us special.
The race is on and he is gone.
I love catching the deep pass because I like how risky it is. And if I get it, I get it. If I don't get it, then So I just like the risky feeling.
Amusu leads the Hawks in receptions. The 3-year starter converted to wide receiver from quarterback after his freshman year.
It wasn't too difficult because I started early and I worked with our old quarterback Cameron a lot. So I worked with the older guys, the older varsity guys, and they took me under their wing and taught me receiver work and all types of stuff like that. So that made the transition pretty smooth.
While the two work on their craft and practice, both guys also look to improve whenever they get a chance.
If I'm just sitting around in my house or anything, all I do is go in my backyard and just grab my ladder, just do little ladder drills, or just go to a park if I find a group of people, maybe just have a little 7-on-7 games, just playing football.
Pedro and Adrian consider former Hawks standout and current Gophers wide receiver Phillip Howard to be a mentor who helped in their development as players. And each guy has a favorite wide receiver too.
Tyler Johnson from the U. I watch him a lot on Saturdays.
I think he does a really, he's really elite and does a really good job at what he does. So I like watching him.
Every single day I watch Randy Moss, like he just how fast he is, how long he is, and how just putting the fear on anybody who guards him is just my favorite receiver of all time.
And what does each of these players see in the other?
He's a good blocker. He's definitely unselfish, blocks really hard, and then he's great to celebrate with. It's fun to celebrate with him, so yeah.
One thing I love about Pedro is that how when he catches the ball, I like how his speed is, and I like how he just make one dude miss and go, and he just flies.
Cooper needs one more win to reach the state playoffs for the first time since 1995. The seniors on this Hawks team are hungry to make that happen.
We've been talking about this since our freshman year. We all were like, well, brother, we've been here since day one. We just, one thing we got to do is reach our goal, go to state.
However, Cooper lost 28-14 at Spring Lake Park in the Section 5 final. Here now is a look at our plays of the week.
They come away Class 3A champions.
Looking for local? Even more local? CCX Media gives you the option to connect with your community on multiple levels. CCX Create welcomes you, community residents, to connect and experience television in an exciting way. The free TV classes we offer will have you on your way to creating TV, and our wide variety of content can be watched at home or on the go. Connect to what's happening in your community. Visit ccxmedia.org. What makes your community feel like home? Is it knowing what's happening in your neighborhood? Or when people know your name? Connections make us a community. For more than 30 years, Northwest Community Television has connected citizens, neighbors, even sports fans through video. You can learn about the latest news through our truly local newscast. We cover and air around 150 high school sporting events every year. For our cities, we air parades and city meetings that you can watch whenever you want. Then, any citizen of our cities can create and share their own original content. We'll even teach you how to use the equipment too. We have always provided you with a connected community experience. And as life gets busier than ever, we will continue to engage, inform, and inspire through CCX Media so you can stay connected to the place you call home. Looking for local? Even more local? CCX Media gives you the option to connect with your community on multiple levels. CCX Sports brings you ultimate coverage in local prep sports with full game coverage of over 120 high school games a year with highlights and features on our daily newscast. Then, our weekly Sports Jam show gives you a close-up look at local athletes, highlights of local games, and in-depth interviews. Our content can be watched at home or on the go. Visit ccxmedia.org.
Our game of the week is a good girls hockey matchup as Wayzata hosts Chaska at Plymouth Ice Center. The game is Thursday at 7 p.m. Watch it live on CCX channel 799 and 12 and online at ccxmedia.org.
And that will do it for this week's show. Thanks so much for watching.
Next week, we'll have state girls swimming and adapted soccer highlights and our first fall all-area teams.